Welcome to the spoken tutorial on creating and viewing inventories. In this tutorial, we will learn to modify the login page to redirect to admin page, to fetch all the book details, to fetch the borrowed book details, to display the books borrowed by a logged in user. Here we are using Ubuntu version 12.04, NetBeans IDE 7.3, JDK 1.7, Firefox web browser 21.0. You can use any web browser of your choice. To follow this tutorial, you must have knowledge of basics of Java servlets and JSPs, database and validation of fields. If not, for relevant tutorials, please visit our website. Now, let us switch to NetBeans IDE. I have created the books table. You can see the different fields in the table. I have inserted 10 books into this table. I have created the checkout table to store borrowed books. I have inserted 5 entries into the checkout table. I have also created a model for book and checkout. Book.java is a book model and checkout.java is the checkout model. Now come to the browser. Let us log in as the admin. So I will type the username and password as admin, then click on sign in. We can see that we come to the admin section page. We will come back to this page. Now let us switch to NetBeans IDE. We will see how we modified the greeting servlet to redirect to admin page. Let us see greetingservlet.java. Here we check if username and password equals admin. If yes, then we redirect to admin section.jsp. We have already seen how to forward to another page using request dispatcher. Now switch back to the browser. We have two options here. We will click on the radio button for list books. Then click on submit button. Here we can see that we have the list of all the books. It has all the details like book ID, book name, author name, ISBN, publisher, total copies and available copies. Now I will show you how this is done. Switch back to the ID. Now let us come to admin section.jsp. Here we have two radio buttons. The first one is to list all the books. We can see that in admin section.jsp we have form action equal to admin section. Now open admin section.java. Here this checks the option that we click on. We clicked on list books. So this part of the query will be executed. We execute the query to fetch books from books table. Next, we create ArrayList to store the details of the books. Then, we iterate through the result set. We create the book object. We set book ID into the book object. Similarly, we set other attributes of the books into the book object. Then, we add book object into the books list. Then we set the array list books into the request. Then we forward the request to listbooks.jsp using request dispatcher. Now we come to listbooks.jsp. In this page, admin can view the list of books. Here first we obtain the books from the request. This HTML table will display the details of the books. So we will iterate through the book list. Here we display the book ID of the book. Similarly, we display other attributes of the books. This is how we display the list of books. Now switch back to the browser. Click on List Borrowed Books and click on the Submit button. We see a list of all the books issued. It has details like transaction ID, book ID and username. Now I will switch back to the IDE and show you the code for the same. Go to adminsection.java. We had clicked on List Borrowed Books. So menu selection is equal to List Borrowed Books. The steps are similar to what we saw for list books. We execute the query to fetch borrowed book details from the checkout table. Then we iterate through the borrowed books and set it into request as checkout attribute. Now we come to listborrowedbooks.jsp. Here we obtain the checkout from the request. We iterate through the checkout list and here we display the attributes of the checkout. This is how we display borrowed books. Now switch back to the browser. In the borrowed books page, we have one more list. The list of books issued when the current date is more than the return date. Switch back to the IDE to see the code. This is done in the same way as we did for borrowed books. The only difference is in the SQL query. In the query, we give the condition return date less than now order by transaction ID. Now I will show you the interface for a normal user. Switch back to the browser. Come back to the login page. I will log in as MD Houston. Type the password as welcome and click on sign in. We get a success greeting page. It has books currently borrowed by the user. It has details like transaction ID, username, book ID and return date. Now let us come back to the IDE. Now we go to greetingservlet.java. We display the books issued in the same way as we did for the admin. Here the difference will be that we have to display the books for the logged in user. So I get the username from this line. Then we fetch the details of borrowed books with the condition username is equal to the logged in user. So, we get the list of books issued for the corresponding user. Then, in success greeting.jsp, we will display the list. This is how your success greeting.jsp will look like. In this tutorial, we have learned to modify the login page to redirect to admin page, to fetch the book details, to fetch the borrowed book details and to display the books borrowed by a logged in user. To know more about the spoken tutorial project, watch the video available at the following link. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The Spoken Tutorial Project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of Talk to a Teacher Project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at spoken-tutorial.org/NMEICT-intro. The library management system has been contributed by a leading software MNC through their corporate social responsibility program. They have also validated the content for the spoken tutorial. This is Arya Ritesh from IIT Bombay signing off. Thank you for joining.